In this video, I'm going to teach you how to use a cool new feature on Draft2Digital to create stunning back matter for your books. That is honestly better than the back matter I generate myself. Seriously, I fell in love with this the first time I saw it. So I'm going to show you how to use it and how to build a list of fans on your Draft2Digital platform as well. Stay tuned and I'll show you how all this works. If you publish your books on Draft2Digital, you may have already heard of the automated end matter tool. Before I explain what the tool is, let me give you a little bit of backstory as to why it was created. If you publish your books on Draft2Digital, before this tool, if you wanted to send an Apple reader to the Apple product page or a Scribd reader to the Scribd product page, it was impossible to do because you can't have store-specific links in your book per Draft2Digital's guidelines. So you can't really do effective calls to action this way. So Draft2Digital introduced the automated end matter tool, which solves that problem. Here's how it works. You upload an EPUB version of your book without any back matter at all. Draft2Digital will then automatically generate back matter pages for you and then send a different EPUB to each of their retailers with store-specific links in it. So, for example, your Apple book would actually have Apple links in the back. Your Scribd book would have Scribd links, Tolino links, so on and so forth. I'll confess that when I first heard about the tool, I wasn't sold on it because it meant that I had to give up some control of my formatting, and I guess wasn't crazy about that. But when I saw it, I wish I had adopted the tool sooner. So I'm going to walk you through step by step how to use it and show you how easy it is and show you also exactly what it looks like so that hopefully it will inspire you to make the leap if you haven't already. Okay, so here we are in the Draft2Digital dashboard. I'm going to show you how the tool works. So we'll start by going into my book, The Indie Author State of the Union, and you can access the new tool from the Layout tab. So here is what the new tool looks like. You can see that it also allows you to add front matter if you choose. Now, we're not going to do that for this example, but just know that it's there. So here we go to our back matter, and we've got an also by. So this will show, I'll put a page in the back of the book that will show all the different books that you've written. And then there's a new release email notification sign up, which we'll talk about that in a second, and the option for a teaser. So if you have the first book in a series and you want to tease the first chapter of the second book, then you can do that. And then you've got the about the author and the about the publisher page, which I guess have about the author selected. So in order to configure these pages, what we'll need to do is go up to my account and then contributor profiles, and you can see I've already got these set up here already. And this is not a secret name, by the way. Jeffrey Foster is a fictional character that writes one of my books. So let's go into Michael's profile, and you can see here this is what it would look like. So let's just pretend that we're doing it from the start. This would be your name under the label field. You copy and paste your bio into the profile field. Make sure you upload an author image, very important, and then a link to your website. Super simple. So once you have all that stuff filled out, we're going to go back to the book page, and we're going to go to the next tab, which is where we can preview the book. So we're going to acknowledge that and download the EPUB, and look at this in Adobe Digital Editions. So we're inside Adobe Digital Editions, and here is the book. So let's jump to the back matter. And here's what the first page looks like. This is the email sign-up page. So as you can see, this looks pretty good. It looks very similar to what we would do in a regular call to action. And I love that they have a button here. So if readers click this button, let's see what happens. So it takes us to the Books to Read site, which is basically a subsidiary of Draft2Digital. And it has another pretty effective call to action. It's a pretty standard landing page. Basically, readers can enter their name and email address in here to get notifications whenever I have a new book. So the downside is that I don't have access to these readers. I don't know who they are, but it's much more effective than the alternative, which is what I talked about in the beginning of this video. So it very well could improve your conversion on Draft2Digital. So this is the also by, which I think is really cool. These are all the books that I've written. And when readers click on these, depending on where they are, it'll take them right to the product page on the specific retailer that they're reading. I think this is pretty cool, and it's way more effective than what we can do by ourselves if we don't use this tool. One of the things to be aware of is that when you're downloading the preview EPUB, that the links here will only take you to the Draft2Digital website because it's a development file. When you actually publish it it'll be reformatted, and the links will be coded to each of the different retailers. So if you're trying to test these, you know, don't freak out if they take you to the Draft2Digital website, because that's what they're intended to do. And then finally, we've got this, which is the About the Author page. Look how clean that looks. And it's just like what you would do in an author page. So this is really cool. And I love the fact that the formatting, it for the most part, matches what I've got in the rest of my novel. So it looks like it fits right at home and like I did it myself. So my big concern when I had first heard about it was that I had no idea what the formatting would look like. But if you're, you know, formatting to formatting standards, then it there's really not going to be much of a difference. And honestly, you know, I like these calls to action better than my own. And so the last thing I want to show you is an image of what happened when I did this for the first time, which this is what sealed the deal for me. It just made it awesome. If you've published other books on the platform and you haven't yet updated those, or if you need to make like a change, then you can also update your also buy pages, which I think is really cool. Because I have over 20 books, so do I want to go back into each of my books and make a change every time I've got something different or when I have a new book out? No. So you can do it in one click. Awesome. So that's the tool. Pretty cool, huh? As I said before, I think it's very cool, and this makes Draft2Digital very competitive in the distributor space. They have consistently proven that their user experience can't be beat. This is, in my opinion, one of the coolest things that they've done. So I want to hear from you guys. Would you use this tool? Are you already using it? If so, are you seeing an increase in sales and mailing list subscribers? I would love to hear from you, because I'm just starting to use this, as well as hear about what you're doing to sell more books on Draft2Digital. If this is your first time watching, I'd love to have you subscribe. Every week I do videos with craft, marketing, and business advice. I also cover publishing industry news that will help you grow your author business, sell more books, and connect with readers. I hope I can play a small part in your future success, because it's time for you to get the author career that you deserve. So subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching.